Today, as we speak, as of June 1st last year, we do not have any unregistered SIM cards on the network. However, we have SIM cards that have been illegitimately or irregularly registered, meaning that we have SIM cards that are registered but are in the wrong hands. And that is what the cure we are trying now to find. And this way we call upon the public to be vigilant on their part, verify how many SIM cards are registered using their national identification number, because there will be people who are able to build the system to get the SIM card registered, but sell it off to unscrupulous individuals. If you want to make history, find the SIM card that is not registered, that has not been released, no name, no name, no date of birth, and present it to the commission. You have an opportunity to share with the commission, but you will make history because the penalty that you got to the company that owned that SIM card, they know. You will make news headlines.
Two of them that we caught are IT experts within a company. It would be just like in the police here. Somebody within the IT department smuggles in a SIM box. It is operating under their table. They're using the institution's internet to do SIM boxing. But the institution may even not know that actually that is happening. And that's why we believe that the people we have are still employees of the actual SIM boxers. They have to be people who are investing in this SIM boxing. So that is why we can't be too specific, so that we do not jeopardize the investigation. We still need the big fish, the people who are putting money. A SIM box could go for about 100 million shillings. Not every Ugandan has 100 million shillings to put in a SIM box.